Abby in the past has told me about women getting their like milk duct clogged.
Well, no, I've had it.
And how the husband would like literally suck out the milk for them. And I quite honestly thought that was a bit of a stretch. So did Abby. Abby was like, I feel like that's just made up. Like, there's no way that anyone ever does that. That just seems weird. It's they probably just have a kink for that crap, you know? Like, let's be honest. It just seems too crazy.
Let me just go.
Okay.
Start from this.
What do you want to say?
I've weaned completely, and by the time of this trip, I hadn't pumped or really hadn't nursed in it forever, but I hadn't pumped for like 10 days. Nothing, not even one time in 10 days. So I was like, I should be in the clear. There's no way I'm going to need to bring a pump with me or anything like that. So we're in the middle of nowhere, Missouri.
758 people in the town that we were in.
Yeah, and then around it is not much either. We were 3 hours away from Matt's parents' house.
There was about a church on every corner and probably seven American flags per person in the town.
Very patriotic town.
I honestly love it. I love the patriotism.
Yeah, but all that to say, there weren't a lot of resources. Like, there was not... I don't know if there was going to be like a clinic.
Yeah, you can't just go to Target and buy a pump. Or
there definitely wasn't a Target. There wasn't a Walmart. There wasn't like a lot of things.
No, the only place to get food in this town, they had a Subway and a McDonald's, and they were both at a gas station.
Yeah, so that, let me just paint the picture there. But as time starts to progress, I'm like, there's something weird going on my left side. There's some tingling, like a little burning feeling. I felt this before, and I was like, but surely it can't be milk because I'm not producing anymore. I stopped all that. And then as the days progressed, and I had this for days, and I was like, it's going to work itself out. It's going to be fine. It started to wake me up in the night with like just not pain, but it's hard. It's the best way I can describe it is like it's similar to when you feel like you have to go to the bathroom. Like,
yeah.
I don't really think that's even that accurate, but moms out there, you know what I'm talking about. If you know, you know. It was just something that was waking me up. My body was telling me something was wrong. And then I start to feel this lump get bigger and bigger. And it got to the point where I literally looked in the mirror and I could visibly see like a lump. And I was like, I can't let this continue because some of you may know, if you have a clogged milk duct, it can get infected and cause an infection called mastitis, which is truly horrible. Like mastitis, I've had bad experiences with it. It's terrifying.
Imagine getting mastitis after you had your kid 9 months ago.
No, I'm not.
Does it happen though? It must happen, I guess.
I'm sure it can happen. And so I could get mastitis, but then also if I got mastitis, I have no access to antibiotics here. And I was really in a tough place.
Yeah.
I was like, I have to do something. So I'm in the shower. I'm like Googling things. I'm in the shower. Also, my phone didn't work. So I did feel kind of like, oof, I don't know what to do. But I did know that I would try to massage it out. I talked to my sister-in-law. She's like, yeah, just get in the shower, massage it out. I'm like massaging. Literally nothing is happening. And so I'm like, what in the world do I do? And so I go to you, Matt, and I'm like, so if you don't want to do this, we're just going to pretend like I never said this and we're going to carry on like normal and we're not going to do this.
No, you actually didn't even bring it up. You just said, my boob hurts. My milk is stuck. Like my milk duct is clogged.
That's what I said. My boob hurts. And my milk is stuck.
Something along those lines. And I was like, do you want me to suck it out? Like I didn't know.
But you didn't seem like me.
Because you kept bringing up the problem over and over again. I was like, I know. I'm like, do you know what the solution is for that, right? I
just wanted there to be a solution.
And so
a different option.
It was one of those things where I was like, do you want to talk about your feelings or do you want me to fix the problem? And eventually, after you brought it up multiple times, I was like, okay, can we just go ahead and do this? Because I feel like you're asking me to fix the problem.
Here's what I wanted. I wanted to bring it up and you'd be like, honey, this is normal. Like, don't feel embarrassed. Like, I know that, like, I wanted you to say, like, the most comforting things but the way you responded, you seemed grossed out at the prospect.
Where do you get these scripts from when I like with what I'm supposed to say for something like that?
I don't remember exactly what you said, and I'm not saying it had to be like script worthy. I'm just saying like I felt embarrassed, which I don't really feel. I mean, we've been together for 8 years. We've seen a lot. We've been through a lot. I don't really feel embarrassed around you anymore. But for some reason, this was making me feel embarrassed. Yeah. And so I was like, I don't want to do this. And then the more I was like, I don't know if I have another option. I tried to get Augie to nurse. He has not nursed for like 5 months.
You tried for about half a second.
He wasn't going to.
You put him on your boob and he went, ah. And before he even finished his like initial ah, you were like, we're done. Like,
Matt, did you think that he would?
You got to try harder than that to get him to latch on. He wasn't going to latch. I will give you that. There was no.
That's what I'm saying. I wasn't going to try harder because there's no way he was going
to
do it.
But I felt like when you were doing that, it was like you have no intention of trying to get this kid to latch, though, when you did it, because it was so quick.
I barely tried because I knew it was a lost cause.
Basically, what happened, I don't even know how to describe this. Do you want to describe it?
Not in any kind of detail.
How detailed do we want to get here?
Not at all.
Okay. I'm going to leave out some different parts of the story, but it was trapped for sure.
So once the clog came out, thanks to Matt, it just started spraying. Like, I would not even, I'm not exaggerating. It was a spray. And Matt was like, get a cup. And so I got a cup, and it's all, there was probably 2 ounces in that cup.
I thought the cup might be a little bit overkill because I had a whole towel to hold down all the liquid and stuff. No, we needed the cup. We probably filled up, what would you say, Matt, a third of that cup?
Okay, Matt's trying to act like it was expired. I'm not a scientist, but I don't think your body can have expired milk.
Dude, that milk was expired. Nobody wants to drink that.
How do you know? That's probably just what it tastes like.
It sat in there for so long. I've tasted your milk has come into my mouth before in other ways. I'm not going to get into detail about that, but in those times, it's actually not tasted bad. I'm like, wow, this is great stuff. Like, no wonder my kids like to drink this.
Tasted different?
Yes, this time it was nasty. Like, I was about to gag with it in my mouth. There was no, because at first I was thinking, frick, do I need to swallow this? I was like, do I literally need to swallow this nasty old, you know, 7 day old milk?
It tasted like spoiled milk.
It tasted like spoiled milk. So I initially was like, I guess I'll just have to drink it because I don't know what else I'll do. But it just made sense to spit it in the cup because I would have thrown up for sure. If I would have had to drink that milk, I would have thrown it up.
I'm done talking about this. This is so nasty and weird.
Just know that if this ever happens to you, don't be embarrassed. It's perfectly normal.
See, I was embarrassed afterwards. I thought that you were you haven't talked about it with me. Like, I was like, oh, I was kind of brought it up. Like, are we okay? Like, is that...
Are we okay?
Like, I'm like, are we okay? Like, is this something we're going to laugh about? Or is this something we're just never going to talk about again? And you've never talked about it. So then I'm like, are you traumatized?
That was very funny.
Are you traumatized?
I'm not traumatized. No. Are you traumatized?
Yes.
Maybe you're... Yeah, you are traumatized. Because you haven't wanted to talk about it.
It's so weird. Well, I mean, I like want to talk about it because I want other people to be like, oh, yeah, the same thing happened to me. It's not that weird. Yeah. But I haven't gotten that response yet. But I know it's happened to other people. So if that's you, just like let me know. Say, hey, it's okay. My husband had to help me out one time. And, you know, I really thought that this was just something that people were like, you know, exaggerating. Like, it didn't need to happen, but they just kind of did that. I don't know. Like, it was, like, a good story for them. No, like, it, like, legit happened, and it needed to happen, and I have video evidence of a cup of it afterwards. It was so gross. So, yeah, I was like, maybe we should give this to the baby. It's 2 ounces of milk, breast milk, and it's got to be better than formula. And you were like, no, it's expired.
It was definitely expired.
So we didn't give it to the baby either. It just went in the trash.